Welcome to our next session, English Lesson 3, Deaf and Mute. We understood the meaning of deaf and mute and blind. We understood, no children? Now we are going to do the exercises. First exercise is new words. New words. First, beggar. B-E-G-G-A-R, beggar. Next, D-E-A-F, deaf, deaf. Number 3, M-U-T-E, mute, M-U-T-E, mute. Next, H-U-N-G, hung, hung. Number 5, THREW, throw. Through is throw, past tense, throw. Throw stones. Then next, number 6, cottage. COTTAGE, cottage. Number 7, blind. BLIND, blind. Next, number 8, shouted, SHOUTED, shouted. Then number 9, laughed, LAUGHED, laughed. Number 10, POCKET, pocket. Once again, children, B-E-G-G-A-R, beggar, beggar. D-E-A-F, deaf, deaf. M-U-T-E, mute, mute. H-U-N-G, hung, hung. T-H-R-E-W, through, through. C-O-T-T-A-G-E, cottage, cottage. BLIND, 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 blind. SHOUTED, shouted, shouted. LAUGHED, laughed, laughed. POCKET, pocket, pocket. Now the second exercise is meanings. Second one is meanings. First meaning word is deaf. What is the meaning of deaf? Deaf means not able to hear. Then second one, mute. That means not able to speak. Then third one, blind. That means not able to see. Number 4, lame. That means not able to walk. See children, only these are there. Deaf, D-E-A-F, deaf. Deaf means not able to hear. When the explanation of lesson also, we understood that. What is the meaning of deaf? Deaf means not able to hear. Next, mute. Mute means not able to speak. Speak. Not able to speak. Next, blind. Not able to see. You can't see. That is blind. Not able to see. Lame. Not able to walk. Not able to walk. These two are the exercise, children. New words and meanings. Your next exercise is textbook page 30. First one, put a tick, T-I-C-K, tick, or a cross, or a cross against each statement, against each statement. You can see it in the textbook page 30. Textbook page 30. The first statement is column. The statement is the tall beggar was deaf. The tall beggar was deaf. The statement is wrong. Sunday children, the tall statement is correct. The tall beggar was deaf. Okay. Then, second one. The fat beggar was blind. Here, the fat beggar was blind. So the answer is correct. The statement is correct. The tall beggar was deaf. What he wrote? So this is children wrong only. Why? Because statement is wrong. Actually he is not a deaf. Here also fat beggar was blind. Actually he is not a blind. Isn't it? The next, they are telling lies. They are cheating others. No. So, the next, the fat beggar was lame. Is children, is he lame? No, he was not a lame. Number four, the beggars were cheats. They were cheating others, no? What they said? The tall beggar said, I am deaf. Fat beggar said, I am blind. And lame also. Actually, they are not deaf and blind and lame also. They were cheating. So, the last statement is correct. Send it. The next page. Put. Second exercise. Put. Tall or fat in each blank, in each blank. Textbook page 31. Blanks are the dash pen. The dash beggar wrote, W-R-O-T-E, wrote that I am blind. I am blind. Who wrote I am blind, children? Fat or tall? Tall or fat? The fat beggar. The fat beggar wrote I am blind. Here, inverted comma, children. The next number 2. The dash beggar, B-E-G-G-A-R, beggar wrote what? Inverted comma, deaf and mute. Who wrote, children? Who wrote deaf and mute? The first beggar. He is a tall beggar. The tall beggar wrote deaf and mute. The next number 3. The dash beggar got some coins. Who got some coins, children? The tall beggar got some coins. Send it. Then number 4. The dash beggar ran back, R-A-N, ran, B-A-C-K, back to his cottage. To his cottage. Why did he go, children? For put the cardboard paper. Then the dash, who? Fat beggar ran back to his cottage. Then as number 5. The dash beggar said that he was blind. He was blind. Which beggar said, children? Tall or fat? Fat. Fat beggar said that he was blind. Once again, you'll see, children, put tall or fat in each blank. First one is, the fat beggar wrote, I am blind. Then, the tall beggar wrote, I am deaf and mute. Then third, the tall beggar got some coins. Fourth one, the fat beggar ran back to his cottage. Number 5, the fat beggar said that he was blind. Okay, then we'll come to the next exercise, children. Next exercise is number 3. Who said these words? Who said these words? These words. Page number 31. See, children, who said these words? We are getting the some sentences. We should write which beggar said that. Okay. Then first one is, I am lame. I am lame. Who said this, children? The fat beggar. The fat beggar. Who said? The fat beggar. The next, second question. Second sentence is, he is a cheat. He is a cheat. C-H-E-A-T, cheat. Who said this sentence? The fat beggar itself. Fat beggar. Same fellow will sit. Then as the third one, He is not deaf. He is not deaf. Who said that? The fat beggar. The fat beggar. Then number 4. God will bless you. Who said this? Again, the fat beggar. B-E-G-G-A-R, beggar. The fifth one is, both of you are cheats. Who said this sentence? A young man. You know this story, children? Are you remembering? Here, who said these words? Textbook page 31. I am lame. Who said this? The fat beggar. He is a cheat. Who said? The fat beggar. To whom did he say? The fat beggar said to tall beggar. Okay. The next. He is not deaf. The fat beggar. Whom did he say? He said to tall beggar. That the tall beggar is not a deaf. Then God will bless you. Who said that? The fat beggar. Last. Both of you are cheats. Who said that? A young man. He realized that these two tall and fat beggars are cheating others and collected the money from them. See the children, these are the exercises. Now we completed new words, meanings and textbook. Three exercises we completed. Write these all exercises in the class workbook and homework book also. Thank you, children.